Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This video I want to introduce one of the built-in app on every Onyx Books device, which is the navigation bar. So it is a system level assistant app that could work on top of every app on this device. So I think it's pretty crucial to this device because, for example, Node Air here, it only has one physical button, and it's the sleep wake power button. The whole device, such a large device, cries for some physical buttons. Their replacement is all in here. So let's have a look at how this app works. So first, how to turn it on. So of course, you can just tap it here and you can on here. So here it is. Another way is to swipe down from the top right side. So this is already firmware 3.2, and you can customize. And when you have your navigation bar in the quick settings, you can switch it on or off here. Okay, so these are two ways to switch it on and off. You can drag it to anywhere. It could stay just in the middle of the screen. When you click on it, it will expand to a lot of functionalities. When you click on this navigation bar, there are 9 buttons where you could customize. For example, the first one is back, but when you click on it, you can choose any of those options. Most of them are quite straightforward. Collapse navigation bar. So let's choose this. It already have it. Right now we have 2 buttons for the same function. So this one and this one. So when you click on it, it will collapse your navigation bar, something like this. And you can type on it to activate again. So this one, I believe, is the navigation bar settings. So let's go back to here. You can change it to open a certain app, any app. Let's open the browser. Why not? E-Ink Pro. Yeah. Let's see how it works. This one? Okay, the app icon will be shown here. Yeah, nice. And let's full page refresh. Here is app optimization. You can optimize the app and screenshot. Okay, it took a screenshot. So let's go back to the app settings. All those 9 buttons, if you notice that there is a pin here. So if you pin it, it will set this button to what they called resident button. This means you have this button on your screen all the time. For example, you can have your full screen refresh always on the screen. So you can refresh every time you want. Another thing is to customize the style of this navigation bar. You can decide whether it opens in a fan shape, in a horizontal shape, in a vertical shape. If I choose a vertical one, for example here, it will open straight up. But if I put it in the middle, where it does not have room to vertical here or here, it will do the fan shape. So it will adapt to your placement and just choose one way that works. So here is the transparency, which I think is a translation error. So when you set the transparency to 100%, it should be totally transparent, but now it's not at all. And when you decrease that value, and it will actually become more transparent. So the lowest number you can go is 20% and almost invisible. The problem is, yeah, you cannot see the icons either. This is not what it used to be in 3.1, I believe. This is a bug they need to fix. And I hope they change the translation here. You can customize the size of it. So this is the largest. And wow, I have never tried this, but the smallest you can get is something like this. How do you use it? Can anyone use this? Maybe use a pen? Yeah, I don't know. So this one is transparency is only valid for resident buttons. So if you have this on and you change transparency to a middle value, and because this ball itself is always on the screen, so it's a resident button, so it will be transparent. But when you click on it, this buttons will be just not transparent. But if you put something on the screen, it will have that transparency. Okay, so if I move it more transparent, it will work. There's another setting is automatically collapse. When I choose this on, it So yeah, this is navigation bar. Is it versatile? Yes, it is. Do I use it? No. I don't like any navigation floating bar on any of my devices. On this device though, it has a great potential because it doesn't have any physical buttons. It could benefit from having a well-designed, well-placed physical button or buttons. So, but this is their choice. Is it good? Yeah, I don't know. I hate it. So yeah, this is the review. I think this is versatile. This is unpolished. A lot of settings don't make sense. You can customize it to whatever you want. You can open apps, and there are some translation errors. There are some bugs. So yeah, this is represent the general app level of Onyx Books device. So yeah, I hope it will become better in the future from my updates, but that's it for now. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.